His new album is called 24 Karat Magic. Please welcome Bruno Mars. Hi, Bruno. Hi, nice to see you again.
See you.
How are you?
Good.
Great to have you here again.
Feels good to be back. It's cold out there.
It's cold out here.
Yeah.
Yes, it's wintry.
Yeah.
and tell me, having listened to your rehearsal here, it's really all about dancing now. It's dance music, isn't it?
Yeah, that's what music's supposed to do.
Yeah, make you dance.
Yeah.
So what, I mean, the internet is full of Bruno Mars moves.
Oh, yeah?
you never Google yourself?
No, never.
Really?
It says Bruno Mars moves.
If you Google Bruno Mars moves, I don't do this often.
You were trying some?
I did yesterday. And to prepare a few moves.
No. Okay.
I did it to just, I mean, I want to, what I wanted to do was see what are the new moves of the year.
Well, I'm your guy.
So, yeah, exactly. So what are your favorite moves?
My favorite.
What is the perfect move this year? The Bruno move.
24 karat magic in the air.
Actually, I've never seen that before.
Well, you know.
Because you do something here.
That's it. Amazing.
Bruno, you call yourself a student of music. What do you mean by that?
Before anyone knew who I was producing music for other artists. And I had to be able to produce for a rock artist, a hip-hop artist, all kinds of different music. So it's my job to study all kinds of music. So I'm allowed to go into the studio and know what they're talking about, know what worlds they come from. So therefore, I'm a student of music.
I've read somewhere about you that you are the kind of musician that have music constantly in your head.
Yeah.
How does that work? Take us in.
How does that work? Take us in there? You don't want to go in there. No, it's just, I'm constantly, for this album, I was constantly thinking about how I could make it better, how I could make the chorus better, different chord progressions, different drum beats. And now that the album's ready and I got to perform, I'm thinking about, all right, how are the lights going to hit? And I want to make sure everyone, we traveled all this way, I want to make sure everyone has a good time. So I'm always constantly thinking about something involved with music.
Do you ever get time off? Does it ever get quiet?
Nah.
What do you do to get some time off?
I like movies. I go to the movies.
You play cards as well?
I do, yeah.
What kind of cards is that?
I used to play poker a lot.
How do you do? I mean, are you any good, or is it losing a lot of money?
No, I used to play a long time ago. For a long time, I actually, that's how I would pay my rent. And then I stopped.
So you paid your rent by playing poker?
Yeah.
So I take it you won more than you lost?
I wouldn't go that far. I had a lucky streak for a while, but at some point it had to come crashing down. You can't, your shoebox of money starts depleting. You know, you have, I had a couple dollars in a shoebox, and then all of a sudden my car breaks down and whatever, doctor bill, and all of a sudden that money's not looking so pretty.
We were talking about that earlier in this program, and I know you don't like to talk about the election. I'm not going to talk about that, but we were talking about class, and I wonder, because now you're sort of pop royalty in America.
Thanks.
But you are, of course. But sometimes before that, I mean, have you ever experienced the other side of it? Have you ever experienced to be really on the other end of the scale?
Yeah. My whole life, I feel like I've been struggling to do what I want to do, and that was music. And it just wasn't easy. I had to go through some things, and but you can't regret it, because I might not be here if it wasn't for that journey that I had to take.
So were you like poor or middle
poor? Poor is an understatement. I was below poor. Well, you see, it started off. My father had a show in Hawaii, and it was a successful show, and we were doing good. We were well off. When my father and mother divorced, lost the businesses, and then that kind of spiraled into getting as poor as it gets.
This is something you just decided, that you were going to be an artist, you were going to be a star.
I was always going to be doing music. I was always going to be doing music. That's all I know. It's been in there's videos of me you could look up on the internet of me as this big singing and dancing, and I'm not good at anything else. And that's all I wanted to do, and I was just, I wanted to take it to the next level. That's why I moved to California and figured out that you have to write your own song. You can't ask anybody. You know, I was going into studios saying, I wish I could. I want to do a song that sounds like this and feels like this. They don't know what you're talking about. So the only way I had to do it myself.
And do you agree that this is also a part of your gambling personality?
Yeah, I think I'm always betting.
It's a huge gamble to just make.
I'm always betting on myself before anything. I bet on me.
Do you have a gambling personality?
I don't gamble.
So that's what the voice is telling you?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Don't gamble.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, yeah. So I'm sure you've taken risks.
Yes, yeah, exactly.
That's really what it's about. Yeah, I mean, maybe it's not gambling. I never play poker and I don't gamble in that sense. But you have to be willing to sort of step out of the...
Absolutely, yeah, absolutely. Go
out of the comfort zone and just go for it.
When you write a song, you very much think about a film. Or in the perspective that you're telling a story.
For this album, because I love music so much and because I come from a producer background and work with different artists, for this album, I kind of tricked myself and said, I'm going to write a movie. I'm going to write a script, and I can see it in my head. I can see me and my band dancing and gold everywhere and women screaming for me when I do interviews.
Sorry, man.
So that's how you envision it.
I just envisioned that. I just envisioned this fun album that made people want to dance, make people want to fall in love, make people want to make love and dance again. Like it was because of my upbringing. There's music that I grew up with that I was dancing. Me and my friends, when I think about the height, like going up in Hawaii. If you didn't dance, girls weren't looking at you. So it was very important that you knew how to dance. And that was the music that was playing on the radio.
And that's the music you make today.
That's the music I aspire to make. I remember that feeling of, wow, this feels so right. This feels so good. So I was just trying to make, with this album, that's what I was aiming for, is to try to capture that feeling and give it to the world.
And one last question before you go on stage. I just wonder, if you were to pick one song that can really get you up on the floor, and it's none of your own songs, right? That can make you... I mean, you're in a disco and the DJ puts on one song. Which song would be the best choice?
The best choice?
I'm going to ask you two afterwards, so prepare.
That's the hardest question anyone has ever asked me. Right now, how I feel... Rick James, Super Freak.
Rick James, Super Freak. I'll make a note of that. And I'm going to play it in a locked room by myself.
Uh-huh.
Very loud when I come home.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Nobody's going to see me. Which one is your favorite?
Love Cats with The Cure.
Hey.
It's a really good song.
I grew up with that
one.
I think it would have to be something with ABBA.
Of course it should be ABBA.
Yeah.
Don't you like ABBA?
Who doesn't like ABBA?
That's
That's
even
like cheating.
Safe bet.
You can't answer safe
that's
bet.
That's like cheating. What's your favorite ABBA tune?
You can dance, you can dance, having the time of your life. Oh,
thank you so much, Bruno Mars. Thank you so much.